Good morning, children. So today we are going to continue our topic. So in our class, fourth class, so I'm going to give a notes to you today. Okay, now I'm giving notes to you, all of you. Just better to write the notes in your notebook. The question and answers I'm giving to you, ma. Okay, now. Right, children? Right. So, now without delay, I'll go for the question and answers, right? The first question is what is habitat? Okay? So, what is that? The first question is what is habitat? Okay? We already discussed about that habitat. What is a habitat? The natural home or environment of an animal, plant or other organism is called as a habitat. Actually, in our textbook, we have some kind of the different type of information is there. But this is a small different type of definition. So, both are same. In your textbook, what it will be there, that is also a habitat. And the natural home or environment of an animal. So, different type of animals are right to present in a one area. Na? So, that is called as a habitat. Okay. Habitat is nothing but different type of animals are right to present in a one place. Like I said already, just for example, a forest is a one of the habitat. Okay, our home is one of the habitat, because the forest means different type of animals, plants and everything, living organisms are there, na? Living things are there, na? That's why that is one of the habitat. And if you go for the home, so different type of animals are there with us also. See here, the human beings are there, and next, so what it will be, and lizards are there, cats are there, dogs are there with us, rats are there with us. So, these are the different type of living organisms are right to present one place, na? That's why habitat we call. Okay, na, children? So, write the definition. So, we'll go for the next answer. Okay, understood? Your wish, if you want to write the habitat is like this, or different type of animals are present in a one area, or combination of a different type of animals. These are all our definitions of the habitat only. Okay, na? So write this information, or otherwise in a textbook also they given the habitat definition. Okay, right. Now we'll go for the next answer. So what are deciduous plants? Give an example. Okay, So deciduous plants means, what are the deciduous plants, and give an example means, see here, I'm giving is a perfect, meaningful and useful information to you all, children. See here, and there are a few species of trees that have characteristics of both the deciduous and coniferous trees. Okay. So these trees grows cones and needles like evergreens, but also change colors and lose their needles annually like the deciduous family. Some trees that fall in this category are larch, bald cypress and the dawn redwood. So these are all the examples. Some trees that fall, na? So these are the examples. Okay, deciduous plants we already discussed. In where we are going to present this kind of the deciduous plants means where the cool areas are there. So some areas are there, na? What does that mean? Some areas very cool and environment is every time that is a snow is ready to fall. The falling snow area is there, na? And that thing is ready to present. This kind of deciduous plants will try to appear in that area. Okay, na? So this is one of the best example, and see that larch, so bald cypress and the dawn redwood. So these are all our examples of the deciduous plants. Okay, na? So in textbook also they given, so different type of examples and definitions they given. So in addition of that, I am giving this information to you. You can write in your notes. Okay. So copy that information, then we'll go for the next slide after completion of this one. Okay. Okay, completed. So shall we go for the next slide? So I am going to show the next slide, Amma. Just a bit. Okay, next one. So name three kinds of aquatic plants. Okay, so here this is already we discussed about the aquatic plants. Okay, so name three kinds of aquatic plants are there, Amma. Okay, in your textbook also they given different definitions, but the big definitions they given, we given as a small, like two to three lines examples of each aquatic plants. Okay, na? The floating plants are there. The floating plants means plants that float on water are called as the floating plants. Correct? The floating plants means what is that, floating plants? So which plants are right to float on surface of water? Okay? And that two examples they given. So duckweed and water hyacinth are examples of floating plants. So duckweed and water hyacinth are examples of floating plants. Okay, so these are the examples of the floating plants. Next one, fixed plants are there, Amma. These are the next one is the fixed plants. So what are the fixed plants? Plants that have the roots fixed to the bottom of the pond are called fixed plants. So simple, the plant's bottom has to fix to the, so the roots are right to fix to the bottom of the pond. For example, lotus is there. Is it a lotus is right to just okay, float on surface of water. Yes, it is float on surface of water, but there is a root is present inside of the pond only. These are the fixed, okay, plants are there. This is the fixed plants are there. Again, I'll read it. Floating plants means that plants that float on water are called floating plants. Duckweed and water hyacinth are examples of floating plants. Okay, and floating plants, that's completed. And next one, fixed plants are there. So fixed plants means, what is that? Plants that have their roots, plants that have their roots fixed to the bottom of the pond, fixed to the bottom of the pond are called fixed plants. Okay, na? Fixed plants means plants that have their roots fixed to the bottom of the pond are called fixed plants. Okay, and next one is there, that is a underwater plants. What is that? Underwater plants. So see here, so in that name only their heading will be there. There is a underwater plants means inside of the water it will be present. Okay, the plants will present inside of the water. Okay, the plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. Plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. Okay, na? Plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. So we already know that this is a different type of examples of plants are there. Correct our children? So definitely there's a different type of examples are there in our day-to-day life. You can see. So copy this information. So we'll go for the next question and answer after writing of this information. Okay, na? So children, write this and name three kinds of aquatic plant they asked. Actually, if you want to write the names only, not a problem. Floating plants and fixed plants and underwater plants. Any three directly you can write that they asked the only names only. But we given extra information, not a problem. Okay? So if you want to write only just names of the aquatic plants, what are the kind of the aquatic plants are there, if you write also, it is okay. It is acceptable. Okay, na? Floating plants, fixed plants and underwater plants also useful and okay. So going to same answer, simple direct answer. So three definitions, three names. Sorry, not three definitions. Three names of the plants, floating plants, fixed plants, underwater plants also, if you want to write, write. Okay, now children, now next we go for the next question answer. So what are underwater plants? Name any one adaptation they have. Okay, so they ask that there is a underwater plants, or what are the underwater plants? They ask that there is a adaptations. So do you know adaptations? Adaptations is nothing but that animal or that kind of the living being is right to move one place to another place. That is called as a adaptation. Adaptation is nothing but moving from one place to another place. So that is called as a adaptation. Okay. So they asked, especially they asked, once you see here, they asked that there is a plant. So underwater plants, what are the underwater plants, and name any one adaptation they have. They given the question separately. So previously what they asked, see here, name three kinds of aquatic plants they asked. So we returned, that is the floating plants, fixed plants and underwater plants also we discussed. But here in this question, they asked that separately underwater plants and adaptations also, that each and every aquatic plants are having adaptations, each and every one. Okay, na? For example, if you go for the floating water plants, floating plants are there. For that also adaptations are there. And what is the next one? Fixed plants are there, na? The fixed plants also having the adaptations are there. And for this underwater plants also having adaptations. So what does that mean? See here. So plants that grow under the water surface are called as underwater plants. See. So this is a, see. Here this is an example once I'm giving to you all. See another point. The plants that grow under the water. So listen carefully. What is a underwater plants means? Plant that grow under the water surface. Are called underwater plants. Okay, now plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. So tape grass and pond weed are examples of underwater plants. Okay, so tape grass and next one, what is the tape grass and pond weed are examples of underwater plants. Okay, now children, these are the underwater plants example. If you want to write the adaptation, okay, I'm going to write here adaptation. See here, children, adaptation. Underwater plants are under, just 1 minute. Underwater plants have thin and narrow leaves with no stomata. With no stomata. Okay, na? So this is adaptations are there, and point wise I am writing, Amma. You can copy this point wise also. So these plants take air. These plants take air. These plants take in air. Take in air through their body surface. Body surface. Okay, na? So these are the answer for that. So this is the answer for that, Amma. So up to this one bit completed. Okay, na? So water, underwater plants, name any one adaptation they have. One adaptation they said. So plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. And tape grass, example I said. Tape grass and pond weed are examples of underwater plants. And now adaptations. So this is underwater plants have a thin and narrow leaves with no stomata. Okay, now these plants take in air through their body surface. So these are the points which we want to write in a underwater plants. So got it, na, children, all of you? So up to we completed this one bit. So fourth bit it is a fourth bit completed questions. So five questions completed in that. Okay na? Five questions completed. Now I'll show from first onwards once you see. So first onwards, what is habitat? Okay. So the natural home or environment of an animal, plant or other organisms is called as a habitat. Okay na? Right, next one. So what are deciduous plants? Give an example. There are a few species of trees that have characteristics of both deciduous and coniferous trees. These trees grow cones and needles like evergreens, but also change colors and lose their needles annually like the deciduous family. Some trees that fall in this category are large bald cypress and the dawn redwood. Okay na? So these are the second answer. Third one, name three kinds of aquatic plants. Floating plants, fixed plants, underwater plants are there. In that, floating plants means the plants that float on water are called as a floating plants. Duckweed and water hyacinth are examples of floating plants. Okay na? So next, fixed plants are there. The plants that have their roots fixed to the bottom of the pond. Plants that have their roots fixed to the bottom of the pond are called fixed plants. Okay, underwater plants. Plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. Plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. Okay, na children? Right? Then next one. What are underwater plants? Name any one adaptation they have. So plants that grow under the water surface are called underwater plants. Tape grass and pond weed are examples of underwater plants. Okay, underwater plants have thin and narrow leaves with no stomata. These plants take in air through their body surface. Okay na? So these are the questions in this bit, answers we given, right? In the next class we will discuss the remaining question and answers. Okay na children?